really smart. Didn't know you were into that.
I love gorillas.
I mean, who doesn't like gorillas?
Do you guys want to know random?
Yeah. Get out! Get out!
Oh, yeah,
it's actually true.
That, those are the girls. The greatest band in the world.
The theme of that profile, the girls are the actually started with the best one.
I love that one. You know the accent?
Sorry?
Yes. This.
Oh my god, yes!
Robin. He's going to be so good.
And they brought back Jim Cummings as well.
That's what makes it better.
Yes. Were you thinking that you were a Disney fan?
Yeah.
Well, not really. What are you talking about? He's universal for life.
No, he doesn't even know what Disney is.
Disney?
Disney?
Okay. Got him.
Does he know the way?
By the way, gotta get credit for those two dead ones right here.
Yeah.
Oh yeah.
This is their wedding. Friendship really is magic. You were so resistant to that hug.
I'm sorry.
Sorry, that's my fault.
I think he's just in shock.
Oh, relax.
Yeah, he didn't know he was getting married today.
If you think this is bad, you can go ahead and have time.
Testing.
We can hear you.
Yeah, you may never know. I mean, there could be people that.
We're not the yellow. DuckTales.
Ah, woo-hoo! I appreciate the reference. Wait, everybody can count three. One, two, three. DuckTales.
Woo! Get the girls that are out there making
it. Race cars, lasers, airplanes. It's a Duckler. I saw a million.
All right.
So, hey, everybody. How you guys doing? So, welcome to the Tuki and Eliam Unexpected panel. I'm pretty sure you guys know who I am.
Who are you?
Good question. But just in case, I'm going to showcase like a brief montage of what my work is. What my work is. So let's showcase this.
Maybe.
Wait, hold on. Sorry.
It is unexpected.
As long as it's not a giant comic.
Because if I would ever come across a talking mutated horse, I would be like.
Ha ha ha!
hours too. So yeah, as you can tell, I like crossovers. So before we actually get started, we're going to introduce ourselves. So of course, you guys know who I am. Maybe not. I don't know.
Who are you? I'm playing that again.
If you still don't know who I am, then why are you even here in the first place? I'm kidding. And then we'll go down the. Actually, we'll start with you since you're the only one this side for some reason.
I love Kim Possible a lot. I promise I'm here for an actual reason, so which you'll find out at the end. So yeah, you can call.
Probably.
Before we continue, let's give a shout out to that Rocket Raccoon over there.
My name is Sherry. I also go by Kira Kiki. I'm the voice actor for Logan, so that's pretty cool. Crystal bust in the Sailor Moon. So yeah, I don't know.
Hi, I'm Diet Black Griffin. No. Hi, I'm Dual Stonator, also known as Thespio, and I am a frequent voice actor for Toucan's animations. You may know me as voicing Discord and Sailor Moon Meets My Little Pony. Who else would it be? But I also voiced Strong Bad in Homestar Meets My Little Pony, and my breakout role for him, I was the old crown, mighty clown prince of crime, the Joker. So yeah, I'm a freaking voice actor for him, and it's working for him has been like some of my favorite projects to do ever. So, but enough about me. This is about him. So.
So yeah. Basically, what we're going to do in this panel is, like, I'm going to be basically talking over, like, how I begin with making these videos, go over the process, how I do make them, and then if we have, like, any backstories we want to talk about. And then near the end, right before we do the Q&As, I do want to showcase three previews for upcoming projects. So one of them will be, well, I'll wait till I talk about that later down the road. But in the meantime, yeah, I might as well talk about, like, how I begin, like, animation-wise. So, after all, I mean, we all love animation, right?
Woo!
Exactly.
No, I hate it!
And so, I guess I want to be a little honest, and I'm kind of considered like a hipster pony in a sense, because I do remember watching the first My Little Pony movie as a kid. Because I remember watching it with my sister, and honestly the most I remember watching from that is that the person who voiced Spike was the same actor that did Cow and Chicken. That's Charlie Adler, yeah. And that's why my first intro to My Little Pony. But as for animation-wise, I'm a huge fan of Disney and all that stuff, so I like to take like influence, especially from the shorts, and most especially like Looney Tunes and Tom Jerry and all that like classic cartoons. Because something about like their humor is like so unexpected, like you don't know where to go, like what to expect from the shorts. Like it can be like a pop light.
Yes.
Take you like those jokes can be like so unpredictable to the point of like you don't know where to go. And have you guys heard of Tex Avery?
Like, yeah.
That's one of my top favorite animators. Exactly, yeah. That's my main influence, because if you watch any of his like cartoons, because let's be honest, but like certain Looney Tunes like Wile E. Coyote and Bugs Bunny, sure they're fun and all, but you can actually tell if you're like familiar with like Looney Tunes and slapstick humor, you can tell where they're gonna go with their humor, especially with Wile E. Like you know he's never gonna win. But with Tex Avery stuff, it's like you don't know what to expect from that guy. I mean sometimes his main characters could win, sometimes he can lose. And it's just like this oddball kind of humor is like you just don't know what to expect from the guy. And that's what I love about it, it's like unpredictability, and that's my number one goal with comedy. It's like you don't want to be predictable by what you want to showcase. Otherwise, you're gonna sit there and think to yourself, "Yeah, I can definitely see that coming from a mile away."
Keeps on your toes.
Exactly. Yeah. So those are like my main influence for like animation, for my humor side. Now for like my style of animation, as you, some of you can tell, it's very like South Park like with like the cutouts and all that stuff.
Exactly. Also Monty Python a bit in a sense too.
In a sense, yeah, with like the live action stuff. And what got me interested in the first place, like I remember watching this one episode of South Park which featured Terrence and Phillip, like the episode centered on them. And at some point in the episode, they showcase Saddam Hussein and had like kind of on now, and they showcase like this realistic picture of him and he had his head like flat up and down. I just found that really funny because he can take like somebody's image and just like mess around with it. And at the time I didn't know who that guy was, but
I think you're talking about the movie.
Well, there's an episode before that.
Oh,
yeah.
Yeah, I can't say the title of it because we're gonna keep things PG, so I can say it. But anyways, so I saw that, so I'm like, I thought that was like really funny, and that's, I wanted to like see him do stuff like that, and like Will said, Monty Python with his humor style of animation for all his cutouts, and I'm pretty sure there's like more out there and all that stuff, so yeah, and all that stuff. I didn't start animating until I'm around like 6th or 7th grade, and what I started doing was stop motion animation, and baby steps, because every time I look back at those, I just, it's not to turn out, you know how like when you create like your first ever project, and you look back and think to yourself, what was I thinking?
Yeah.
Unfortunately, I don't have any of them saved. I remember making this one where it's like, who killed Big Bird?
Oh, what?
I know, it's like basically what happens, like, Elmo was on an investigation, like who killed Big Bird, and at the end of the turn, that would be like this green Play-Doh guy, and it's like, no reason as to why he did it.
It's
Gumball. Not Gumball. No, it's like a literally green Play-Doh with no face or anything. And
Gumby, yeah.
And so, I don't recommend watching it, if I still have it. But it wasn't until like much years later until I realized I can actually animate with Photoshop. Which, by the way, in case you guys don't know, I do animate with Photoshop, iMovie, and Adobe Premiere. I know in most cases people do animate with Flash. And people have convinced me to try to do so. I haven't tried it before. I'm pretty sure it must be easier than like this Photoshop. Because the process, I could explain the whole process how I do my animation, but it'll take like 20 minutes or so. But I'll put it simply, think like stop motion with like the frame by frame motion, but with saving like a Photoshop document. And it sounds time consuming, but hey, animation is time consuming overall. So, I mean, I'm pretty sure Flash might be easier, but then again, I'm no Flash expert, so I mean, I'm good with doing with that. So yeah, that's what I know. When it comes to like making MLP content, even though I became a Brony since 2011, I didn't really thought about doing any videos related to My Little Pony because at the time I was a closet Brony, so I was like really open about it. But it wasn't until like after I graduated high school, I thought to myself, you know what? What the heck? I was like, I'm gonna like do it, see what happens. And does anybody remember the video My Little Pony Unexpected?
Yes.
Yeah.
I'm surprised some of you actually remember that. So, basically what it, for those who don't know, basically what it is like, Pinkie Pie enters a jerky corner, she knows that it's a party, and she goes on this crazy run, like stealing everybody's treats and such. And at the end, she got diabetes. Yeah. I wish I could showcase a clip to you guys, but I don't have one with me. But let me just say that at the time, I was still kind of like learning the basics, like how I can make my animations. Because if you go back and watch my older stuff, the way the characters talk, it make it look like they have like bobbleheads. Like, hey, how are you guys doing right now? Oh, it's good, right? Yeah, it's hard for me to look back and watch my videos, older videos at least. And so I made that. I got some of my personal friends to do the voices, and it took me like I think like 2 weeks to make the whole project because at the time I basically used Photoshop and iMovie. I didn't have Adobe Premiere at the time, and by iMovie I mean like the old version of iMovie, not the current iMovie.
iMovie
HD.
I just have so much respect for you.
Thank you, Brittany. And so, once I have that video finished, I upload it to YouTube, see what happens. I decided to share it to Equestria Daily, just because. And honestly, I didn't come to expect how somewhat positive received that video got for what it was. And people were like commenting, saying like how much they love it, they want to see more MLP stuff from me. And it was at the point where it's like even Rena Chan, Kier Buckley, actually offered, sent me an email saying like she wants your voices for my videos. And it's like, man, this is serious. And so I was like, because after I released that video, I didn't have any no plans on making more MLP related videos. I just thought I'd just do the one just for the heck of it. And seeing how people really like that one, I was trying to like come up with like different ideas like what I could do for my next project, which at the time I had nothing to come up with. At one point I was thinking like doing one where it's like somehow Pat Bloom managed to get to the real world and interact with a couple of things, but that didn't really go anywhere. And so it wasn't until like one day where I thought to myself, what would happen if Batman were to meet My Little Pony? Yeah, I know it sounds silly, but at the time I was like still kind of young, out of high school, all that stuff. At one point I was considering making Batman like a pony version of Batman, but I couldn't really get the design to work very well. It just looks more, I don't know, like doll to me. So I decided like went ahead and like use that like, technique of like taking like still images of like the Batman and just make it work and all that stuff. And that was at the point where I met
Sherry,
because she voiced Fluttershy in that video, and going forward she voices Fluttershy, Pinkie, and a few other characters. And so I went over to her house, we did a couple of voices, I get to introduce myself to her, and how was that like for you, the process, the voicing?
I think it's really fun. I mean, you get to explore any voice that you have inside of your head and just, you know, make people laugh and smile with it. It's
awesome. Mm-hmm. Remember I tried to do my impression of Flesh, I had to get like, I'll just say, it is some of the creepiest stuff ever. I'm not going to demonstrate, but you get the point.
Come on.
Do
you know
it.
What the heck?
Do it. Hi, I'm Fluttershy.
Yeah, you're probably going to take it a one step further. You'll be like, yay. That would be unexpected. I don't know about your name. So, there you go.
True point. Yeah,
that
is.
Can we have a bird just go yay
like one? We could, yeah. Just back a bit. You may never know with my stuff. Yo, man, tweet. You guys remember the Rapunzel video? Buzz, 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 man, buzz. Yeah, I don't know why I just find that funny to do that. But,
friggin' Ryu.
Unexpected. But, anyway.
I thought I was gonna die when I saw it.
Honestly, oh, just a side note, now you mentioned that, every time I do like a fight sequence or something like when it requires a montage, I don't write that in the script. Basically what I do for the most part for the voice actors is like I put in like, insert fighting noises here and then I'll do the rest because I just go along with the animation and see if I can come up with like ideas what to do for like fight moments. Good examples is with Godzilla, Meets My Pony, with like how Spike and Godzilla are fighting each other. I just basically just went along and see what I could come up with, and especially with Sailor Moon.
Oh, my God.
Yeah.
Every time I watch that, when the fight starts, I'm like, prepare for madness.
Yeah, I can vouch for that. When I got the script for that specific project, he just put in parentheses, just make various fight noises, and I was surprised the good majority of my improv made in the final product, especially in like that. Oh, ha, parrot, spin, hook, thrust. Why does nobody know how to use this? So,
yeah, that's another thing too. I love it whenever the VAs do like improvise their lines because it gives me more material to work with. A good example is with going back to Sailor Moon. There's this one moment where we see like Discord and Sailor Moon driving the Ford Fusion. And originally the script was says like have Discord said like, wow, you're right, Sailor Moon. This Ford Fusion really is the best driving car, whatever. But enough selling out, let's get to the business. And so I sent the script to Will. You want to describe it, Will?
Yeah, basically, when I saw that line in there, I was reading the script with my now fiance Katie Patterson. We were looking over it, and I just thought to myself, okay, he mentions the Ford Fusion. I know that there was a legit commercial for that car featuring all the characters from Sailor Moon. Why don't we add on to that? Give him a little extra fun. So we had Katie record that commercial line. It's like the new 2018 Ford Fusion. Because selling out to Weeaboos is the only way we can compete with those stupid Toyota Priuses. So, but yeah, we decided to add on to that, and I included it in my file and said, here, we added some extra stuff. Have fun.
And after I listened to it, I was like, yep, I definitely have to do that. And funny enough, I actually do own a Ford Fusion, so it worked out perfectly, because going into like the live action portion, I contacted Sherry to be the model for that Ford Fusion scene. And I think we did, like, how many takes?
I don't know. I just remember when I did Carbon one time, my hat fell off.
Yeah, her hat fell off. Did your sunglasses fell off the whole way?
Yeah.
Yeah, we did so many takes, and I was a camera operator. And that's my actually first time blending in, like, animation with live action. And because at the end, Discord appears on screen, so like, okay, that's enough of that. And then Sherry interacts with him. And basically how that process goes, like, when I took it to Adobe Premiere, I basically took the scene with Sherry, and then I had Discord later on. And because I was moving the camera at the moment, I don't want to have Discord just like placed on there, otherwise it'll look like it's floating. So what I end up doing is, frame by frame, I move Discord slightly to the camera, and so that way he's like somewhat moving with it. And let's say that process took like maybe like an hour or so, just to make sure it looks right to my eyes. Yeah, so.
That must have been really hard.
At first, yeah, but it's not really hard, it's more tedious than anything. But I'm used to it, so that's good.
Yeah, tedious.
Yeah, well, plus too, like with each new animation you do, you add a little something extra that you've never added in previous stuff. It's like you're continuously, it is still a bit of a learning process to try to make your next project better than the previous one. And, you know, with you getting the knowledge and learning more skills, it's like, oh, I could use this and something I never really thought of before. It kind of goes in a cycle like that, which I can attest for, because before I decided to, just go on a bit of a tangent here, before I decided to voice acting full time online, I actually tried my hand at some animations when I was in high school with my old train set, and I kind of animated in a similar style, but it was mostly just with facial expressions. And unlike him doing it in Photoshop, I did all of mine in MS Paint.
Oh, so, gosh.
So I have to give you a lot of credit for that.
Yeah, it was a tedious process, but I enjoyed learning the ins and outs of what it takes to make something like this, like especially frame by frame. And like I was learning about it in college at the time too, like even like 3D animation and stuff like that. But I felt like, give it a bit more traditional look. So yeah, MS Paint was my go-to thing, and because I couldn't afford any Photoshop at the time. But seeing how he does it, it made you respect for it, because you know, I kind of animated in a similar style back in the day, so.
Right, and I was familiar with your stuff before the phone Brian Fanda. I think the first video I watched was like Hamlet with trains.
Yeah, it was this old thing I had to do for a high school English project, and it's the cringe is strong with this one.
Don't worry, well, like I said, we've all been there.
It's
I remember when I first watched that video, the thing that caught my eye, or ear in this case, was the way that Will delivered his lines. Because I gotta say, you're probably one of the best streamers when it comes to like voices. Because the way you shout out your lines are like so, it makes me laugh so hard because of how like perfection it was.
I've noticed a lot of people that do want to get into voiceover, they kind of hold themselves back. And like, if you do want to make this a future career, it's like, I've taken a lot of classes on the subject, it's like, no, if you really have to go full out, like, don't just be like, I'm being stabbed, I guess, I don't know, maybe. No, nobody's going to say that. You really have to go on and actually scream bloody murder, in a sense, really go all out. Be willing to bust a lung for the art, in a sense, but don't actually do that, but yeah.
That would be dangerous.
Yeah, diaphragm. But yeah, just don't be afraid. Don't be afraid to hold back when it comes to acting, because if you're not feeling it, the audience is going to notice that immediately, and just like that, they're not going to care.
Do you remember the Slenderman?
Yeah. Okay, we're going to keep this PG, but I'll say this much: when I first released the Slenderman video, Oh, yeah.
I think I'm
asking you another question. No, never mind. Going back to Slenderman, do you want to explain that part?
You go ahead.
So basically, I was over at her friend's house, and we were like recording the lines, and there's this one moment where it's like at the very end, she's gonna like really sell it with her performance by her crying as Fluttershy. Mm-hmm. And I think we did like, what, 4 different takes on that? Mm-hmm. And there's one moment where like you're basically like lumbering your lines, like, you want to demonstrate it, you remember?
No, I
can't
remember,
right.
I thought I was like really fast and cool.
Right, let me see if I can try to imitate it. It's like, oh, Rainbow Dash, thank you so much. I love you.
Yeah, those are the best moments
when
you like, accidentally do something like that.
Yeah.
And just like, you laugh at it for hours.
But yeah, what I thought you were talking about earlier is like, going back to Slenderman, when I first released that video, the majority of comments I got were like, should I even say it?
Spooky.
It gets spooky, I'll say that much. Let's just say it involves like tentacles. And at the time, I didn't know what that was, so I ended up like Google searching it.
Oh, you poor soul.
I know.
Not so,
poor
man, I'm sorry.
I know, I regret that.
Some things you should not Google.
Yeah, it's really bad.
I mean, it's a long list, but that's
a long list. Along with Disney
on board. Yeah, my advice, never type in like an obscure cartoon show on Google Images because it's not going to be pretty. I'll say that much.
I repeat, poor bad.
But anyways, exactly. So going back to Batman, basically, ever since I released that video, I didn't really intend to make like a series of the whole thing. The thing, like, if I didn't add Spider-Man at the very end for that little cameo, saying like, hey, look, talking ponies, that just made my day. And I remember like people commenting saying like, hey, this should be like an episode dedicated to Spider-Man. Hey, we should see another one of Spider-Man. And I was like thinking to myself, you know, I should do something with that. I should make a whole series with like these random characters, like me and the My Little Pony characters, just for the lulz and all that stuff. And there's one particular video that wasn't really intended to be part of the series, but I decided to add it anyway. It's a G3.5 Scootaloo episode.
Ah!
I
thought where Godzilla destroys G3.1.
Yeah, but that's a different video. The one hit. It's like the one. Yeah. I gotta say, not gonna lie, that's kind of like one of my personal favorite episodes because call me crazy, but I kind of like G3.5 Scootaloo. But in a more like a so bad, so good kind of way, because if you guys seen that one short of the newborn cuties?
Oh god.
Yeah. Yeah. It's the pony equivalent of the room for you.
Basically, yeah. It's just like,
kill me.
Every time I watch it, it's like, I can't help myself laughing at like how terribly everything's executed.
They just
put it
into my eyes.
It's funny, got the credits on one of them, they actually put it in the G3.0 credits, so the wrong people would.
Yeah, but does anybody really care for G3 ponies?
No.
True. Yeah, I do remember that.
In the same sense, it's like some things that are really this bad, they turn out to be good. Almost like in the same sense that if there's too much good, then it's bad, sort of thing.
Right. But hey, it's in the past. We're in G4, soon it possibly be G5, but. That's for another time. But ever since then, people really want me to do Spider-Man, and once I get to the point of Spider-Man, let me just say this much. Despite being my most viewed video on my channel, and despite being like how everybody really loves that video, I absolutely hate it so much. Mainly because that's my first time doing like a legit request video, and there's like so many different possibilities I can do with that video, because originally, it's going to be so much different how it turned out to be, because just a fresh reminder, basically in Spider-Man Meets My Little Pony, it's just had Spider-Man interacting with the ponies, doing some like crazy stuff. At one point, he beats up Spike, threw apples at Applejack because he thinks like bits are like real gold. And then at one point, Rarity like hits him with a broom and all that stuff. It's going to play out differently because originally it's going to set up Spider-Man into a ponytail. But at one point, the ponies are being threatened by a timber wolf, and so they're swearing to defeat him, and the way he's going to defeat the Timberwolf is by grabbing a match, light it, and then just threw it at the Timberwolf and set it on fire. Yeah, I thought that would be like too dark for what I've been doing, and I want to keep things like, you know, not too threatening for young kids, because I'm sure there's kids watching my stuff. I mean,
you make it kind of like Lucian, where they just turn black and they turn to dust.
I could have done that, but I was like still new, like this whole process, so I decided not to do that, and went like
lost time.
Yeah, and basically copy all elements from the Batman video, and I just feel like that's just like way too similar to the Batman video. So because this is at the time where the Spider-Man meme was popular, the 60s Spider-Man. So I try to like blend that element with the original Spider-Man, like how he can be like a jerk sometimes. If I were to do Spider-Man now, I would have gone with the Tom Holland Spider-Man. And best Spider-Man so far.
What's the movie here?
The MCU. Spider-Man Homecoming. Yeah, sorry. So, yeah, every time I like look back at that video, there's like so many problems with that video in my end of things. Like, originally I was going to have like Rainbow Dash fly throughout the whole video instead of being on the cloud. But, okay, here's the way I do certain things. If I want to do like more than one thing happening in the scene, I tend to have my characters on the green screen because, like I said, I don't use Flash. So the best way I can do is to have characters on the green screen. And then when I go to Adobe Premiere, I can always like keyframe it so that way, ultra keyframe it so that I can get rid of the green. So I was animating Rainbow Dash flying throughout the whole project. And it wasn't until the very end after I'm done finished there, I was thinking to myself, wait, she has green under her mane. I was so mad at that because I did not realize that. So what I ended up doing is like, I went, instead of like re-animating the whole thing again, I decided just to put her on a cloud, give a little name excuse, saying like, oh, her wing's broken, and just went from there. And surprisingly, nobody complained about that. Because I felt like that would be like an easy route, but eventually down the road, I managed to make her flying work. So yeah, there's that. And yeah, I'm trying to think what else. Sorry, I'm just like blanking here for a second. It happens sometimes. Another episode that I didn't really like that much is, you guys remember the Sophia the First episode? It's like one of our shorter ones.
Yeah.
Sophia the First. It was like the
Pickles.
Oh,
yeah.
Basically, that's another project where it's going to be like taken differently, because instead of like having her open the pickles, Sophia would accidentally send like a plague of rats to her kingdom. And I thought like the more I wrote the script to it, the more darker it got. And I don't want to like scar any kids. Because given like the title of Sophia the First, you know there's gonna be little kids watching that. So I figured go look to the lame route and have her like can open a jar of pickles, because I was watching Powerpuff Girls at the time. The good Powerpuff Girls. So I ended up doing that, and I wasn't really proud of that one. But it comes like there's some few pickups down here and there was no project, so. Now, let me just say this run, the majority of comments I do receive on my channel, on my videos, is like requests for like certain characters. And let me just be, I'll be honest, I do like those, but at the same time, it's like, I'm not that big a fan, because that's like the majority of the comments I do receive is like requests. And honestly, the thing that's really tough about that, it's like, I gotta know the source material. If not, then, let's say, give me something.
Deadpool.
Something else. Because I know Deadpool.
And
that's right. Well, stuff like that, I can't like force in that project. Otherwise, then it'll be like forced, rushed, and not well executed. Because
it has to feel natural.
Exactly. Even though I love Ed and Eddie, I can't really feel like a scenario like how's that gonna work interacting with the ponies, because the process for me is like, I gotta make sure like, how are they gonna interact, what kind of jokes I can put in the video, and go from there, because I can't just make like a humorless video, otherwise you'll be sitting and being bored out of your mind.
I mean, I feel like
we need all the PG jawbreakers. Yeah, but that seems too obvious.
I get the problem.
Yeah, that's another thing too, it's gotta be like, not too predictable, because at one point I was thinking about doing like Indiana Jones meeting Darren 2, but I thought, you know, that would be too obvious, and also somebody else made a video related to that, who may or may not be wearing a Gilo costume. there's some other projects where... yeah. And there's been other projects that like I had in mind that I really want to do, but I haven't got time to do so. Some good examples being Duck Hunt, Super Mario Brothers, Link from Legend of Zelda, Darth Vader. Sound effects. Fair enough. The poem, The Raven. That would have been a good one, yeah. I'm still debating on that one, but I'm not sure.
It's a Wild Man special.
I know, right? Hey,
there you go.
Did you
already do a special? Or not yet? There we go. Yeah. Technically with like Slenderman and... The true fully canceled project was the Freddy Krueger video.
I wanted to see that one.
Yeah, the main reason why I canceled that is because I was originally going to plan on working that after I'm done with the Rapunzel video. I thought that would be like the next Halloween video for 2014. But at the same time, I was like working on Godzilla. And I thought, you know what, I should put this on hold just a little bit. And I figured like, yeah, I can always come back to it later. A year later, the episode where the Kingdom Hearts series finally got their key marks. Yeah, that just like blew any chance for that project that ever happened. So I decided just to cancel it. But I find, you know, not to go to complete waste, I decided to like, showcase like still images of the project itself. So you guys have some idea how that's going to work.
Like an animatic storyboard.
Basically, yeah. Funny thing, having digital storyboards, I know a lot of animators use that. I'm one of the few that don't. Mainly because... the reason why is because I fear since I'm the only animator, I have like the same vision how everything's going to be played out. And also, it'll just be taking too much time for me to actually like draw everything in storyboard mode, because I want to make sure I have these videos out of time and like not have this extra space in between. Because the Sailor Moon project, 34 minutes in total, and that took like a whole year for me to make. And while it was fun to work on, don't get me wrong, it was probably one of my personal favorite episodes. It's just been too much time for me to like take away too much of my work on other projects. So I figured with like these next couple ones, I figured, you know, make them short, simple, and to the point. Which, speaking of which, I think now should be a good time to showcase the previews for my upcoming projects.
Yeah.
Yeah, I have a request. Sorry.
I had so many good ideas.
All right. I guess there's
you a way. Animate your own ideas.
No, I'm not good at drawing.
I'm one to talk,
right? Yeah, let's get this light right here for us.
Alright.
Yeah, but he's first.
He's first.
If you guys want to line up, that's
yeah,
fine.
Yeah, everybody line up, you have a question.
I'm not sure if that might work, but it probably works.
It works. So, my question that I've had on my mind for a long time, why do you hate Lyra and Bombard so much?
I get that question a lot, but I'll explain anyway. Okay, so at the time when I first started the fandom, you know how like Lyra and Bombard are like very popular in the background ponies? Like, I just don't understand how they became popular. Like, Derby, I understand. Dr. Wolf, or Dr. Hooves, sorry. Dr. Hooves, I understand. Lyra and Bonbon, what makes them special? I get, like, the reasons because they, like, there are, like, some episode where they, like, stand next to each other or something like that. And the whole Lyra, like, inhumans thing, I was still confused. I guess somebody told me, like, there was, like, one instance where she sat down, like, a human.
Yeah.
And it's like, that's not a good enough reason. So I just figured, like...
Sorry, have you heard the internet?
So I thought it'd be, like, a fun little jab just to make fun of the whole process, just having, like, injured every episode. But lately I've been stopped doing that because I feel like that seems, like, way too mean-spirited because they haven't, like, done much to deserve it, so... And that was back at the time where I did the voices for them, and,
you know, the joke brands course.
Exactly. It's kind of, yeah, so all running gigs must come to an end eventually, so... Hopefully I answered your question.
Yeah, thank
but
you.
But now, honestly, lately I'm becoming more of a fan of Lyra and Bonbon ever since the Slice of Life episode. Ever since then, I was like, I want more of them.
Okay.
Well, you know who I am.
Who are you?
No one. Anyways, I know that you did like a somewhat like 100,000 subscriber special where you go to Equestria as a short. Have you ever thought about actually doing like a full episode about that, or was that only just a one-time thing?
Just a one-time thing.
Really?
Yeah.
I think it would be a good idea if you actually made a full episode of that.
That's the thing about myself, is like, I'm not really a big fan of doing sequels with my videos. I mean, there's some exceptions, like, of course, the Joker, but honestly, it's not really my thing to do with, like, sequels, because I want to more, like, have more variety with my videos. Because I know with, like, the Loud House episode, people wanted me to do, like, a legit one, because it was, like, an April Fool's joke, and it's like, no, it's just, like, one-off thing. I got more projects to deal with, so, sorry. I mean, maybe.
But I do have one request.
No. Okay. Wait, I'm curious.
What's the request?
Okay, so.
Never mind.
Is there any My Little Pony meet that you will not do? Not because it's something's too difficult, you don't think you could come up with a good story, just you refuse to do it.
Oh, there's plenty. At one point I was considering making a video dedicated to that, but honestly I just don't have the time to do so. But I will give you one example. Any real life person, it can be like a celebrity, it can be like a YouTube person, or it can be like any one of us, except with exception being myself.
Or a awful lot of
yeah, but technically that's your OC, so you know.
Yeah.
But no, the reason why I don't do like real people is because of two reasons. One, I'm not really one to make fun of celebrities. It's just not really my thing. Because what if you don't know the person? Like, I get like requests doing like, let's say, Justin Bieber or Donald Trump or One Direction or just those kind of people. It's like
Miley Cyrus.
You know, Miley Cyrus is one of them. Yeah, it's like,
what are you talking about? Those targets are just too easy.
Exactly. Or just that. Basically, any real life person. And the second thing is, I'm afraid like the video itself might be outdated because no joke, at one point I was considering doing like a Honey Boo Boo Meets My Little
Pony. Oh, please no.
But I figured the more I thought about it, the more it was like way too mean spirited because it didn't really deserve the hate. Honestly, it's more like the exact.
Well, I mean, technically you did do like a sort of spin-off thing with Apple Boo 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 kind of thing.
That's more.
But that was just like a one-off thing for Pinky Rose.
Right, that's different. So that's, I mean, I can do like some appearances of like that, but when it comes to like actually showcasing like a celebrity or per se, it's like not really my thing. Unless it's like for like a really brief joke, that's about it. Like when you saw Rick and Morty, you saw like those people flash and raise eyes. And those are just basically people that I absolutely hate. Like you saw like at one point you saw like Donald Trump, you saw Logan Paul in there, you saw
Hitler.
Hitler, yeah. Just all those people.
Hitler,
My Little Pony. But if you look very closely, you can see it. But,
all right.
Yeah, actually, not gonna lie, that's another voice I got a lot too. I don't know why, but.
Can you believe?
Yeah. Good night, everybody.
Hello.
Who is this handsome guy?
Nobody.
Looks like some pony who watches a lot of pony.
I've watched some things.
Anyway,
this is a question for all of you. It's a great way to get to know people. What is your favorite ride at Disneyland?
Oh boy. You can't be any ties or anything like that?
Let me remind you.
Okay, yeah. Honestly, for me, it's a tie between Thunder Mountain and Space Mountain.
I actually really like the Guardians of the Galaxy ride right now.
Yeah,
it's amazing.
I really like the Haunted Mansion. It's really cool. I really like the dance.
Good that you get.
The scene with the ballroom. And, yeah.
Yep.
We got to see how they actually do that in the teleproduction class
like
in high school.
Yeah, that's
and
what
they have this film like, that right stretches its own script and it makes you see images and not see images. And it's just cool to see it in person because we went backstage and got to see it. So I like that.
Yeah, get me like really quiet. If we were to talk and we were kind of kicked out of the park, getting the sneeze. So it was a fun experience.
Yeah.
Mine would have to be there's two different ways to put this. Fair ride, Expedition Everest, despite the Yeti not working.
And
fair show would have to be the Enchanted Tiki Room for obvious reasons. Let me just add this, my least favorite ride would have to be Buzz Lightyear. And honestly, it's more like I'm not really good at that ride. Like, the latest one, it is hard. I can barely see where my dot line is.
Yeah.
So, Toy Story Made by Radio is like a high, it's much more better, superior version. But, anyways.
I'm gonna say Space Mountain too. Because I'm not a fan of drops, and the drops aren't too intense for that one. I've done Expedition Everest, and I'm recently, like 2 weeks ago, and I'm just like, I'm too old for these drops. Yeah, I was in Disney World. I lost my KP, it was those. Yeah, I like Rocket Ambition, classic stuff too.
Definitely any of the classics, Mr. Toad all the way.
Did you guys know that people throw remains in Rocket Mansion?
Yep.
Yeah, that's weird, but.
You don't know that? Yeah.
Don't they vacuum it up after
the game?
What was your last video to use iMovie, or do you still use it?
I still use iMovie for animation. Yeah, I should say my last full project that I worked specifically on iMovie would have to be the G3.5 scale video.
Okay.
Ever since then, I still use iMovie, but afterwards when I do the file editing, I use Adobe.
Hello.
Can we raise it?
So,
but that's fine.
It's on. Yeah, it's on.
It's on. Okay. Or I can just basically shout to all room servers. Anyways,
that works too.
Like since after the Tangled episode where Verily meets Rapunzel, but like. I sort of would have thought that she'd gotten over her suspicions of the evil human beings and all that sort of stuff. Otherwise, in that case, I thought she just attacked him because of his clothing line and his choice of color at that point for his clothing.
There will be one line in that video where she kind of explains why she doesn't like humans except for Rapunzel. She's like the one exception. But yeah, I kind of did break continuity a little bit with the Rapunzel video, but you know, they gotta make sacrifices or stuff like that. Like I said, there's some scenes I want to put in certain videos, but because of timing or if this doesn't feel right, I just end up deleting it. There's so many things instead of that I really wanted to do, but for timing, a good example would be at the very end. How many of you are familiar with Sailor Moon? Do you remember what the Sailor Moon says? Yeah. I was gonna do like a parody of that.
Yeah. The Sailor Moon part was like your best one so far. That right. is until we see all what we got the previews out of course.
Right.
Like, who's to say? Like it's just me. It could be something else with a different preference, but who knows?
Right. I mean, we'll have to like on.
At least you have my preference, and you have pretty much everybody else's preference. You ain't that right?
Right. But anyways, there was supposed to be the scene at the very end of the video where we showcase like a live action Sailor Moon, which also would have been played by Sherry. But because of her, you know, the conflicts, we couldn't be able to do so. And plus, I think it's for the best. If we were to do like two live action scenes, that would be pretty redundant. So I think it's for the best we did. So it's basically going to be having her like spew some nonsense moral, like, what was it? Like, don't make sure you brush your teeth or something, or something generic.
Yeah.
So. And then we're gonna have like plushie of Luna, which I would have done like the voice of Luna, being like, "Oh, Sailor Moon, what do you think you're doing?" Something like that. So, oh, it's good fun.
They kind of sounded like Mickey Mouse a little bit.
Oh! Oh wait, I gotta work on that. I gotta drink more water. Oh, so well, boys and girls! Don't mess with me!
Good time. Fun story. We're at leisure at Disneyland. We were keep doing like the Mickey Mouse voice, but we're like exiting World of Color, and the people like in front of us like give us like dirty looks, like what are they doing? Like we weren't like Christmas. But yeah.
All right. Well, that whole Mickey Mouse thing was just me talking, but
yeah.
You know, after hearing that question about your favorite ride at Disney World, I thought this would be a nice one too. What would you consider your favorite Disney movie?
Live action or cartoon?
Animated cartoon.
The CGI or hand drawn? If I had to go with CGI, I would say it's a tie between WALL-E or The Incredibles. For hand drawn, I would say Aladdin.
Oh yeah, that's a good one.
I'm going to say it's a three-way tie between Winnie the Pooh, Lilo and Stitch, and Zootopia.
Ooh, those are good ones.
I'm with Britt on the Winnie the Pooh train. I love Winnie the Pooh as well, and I love the original Alice in Wonderland, the cartoon one, of course. It's such a great movie.
You asked me a really hard question.
Sorry.
No, honestly, if I were to pick one, my absolute favorite has to be Pinocchio. Many realize that's a film that does everything right. I mean, if you go back and look at the animation for that film, like this is from like the 40s before computers was a thing. So if you watch like the monstro scene with like the water, somebody actually hand drawn the splashes off the water, and it's like, wow, that's really impressive. But yeah, Pinocchio, second favorite has to be Hunchback.
Those are both.
I have a mental list. But it's like. Little Mermaid, stylistically, I love Little Mermaid stylistically. Ariel's my favorite. Hunchback, Lion King. There's a fourth. I think that's it. There's one more, but I can't remember it. Oh, Treasure Planet. I did a 20-minute review on it.
I like Aladdin.
Oh, actually, I'm gonna make an addendum to mine. WALL-E and Incredibles, those are times for my favorite Pixar movie, for my favorite Disney 3D animated movie. A tie between Zootopia and Wreck-It Ralph.
I was gonna say,
oh, yeah,
So,
just let that one go.
Mine's pretty obvious.
Alright, so, it's Alice in Wonderland, right?
Right. No. We got 5 minutes, so let's make these last two quick.
Yeah, let's speed through these.
What was the most difficulty in animating? Something that was hard for you to animate?
Honestly, it's more like I'm used to animation, so nothing's really hard for me. But I would say, kind of get used to is like new character models. Like not talking about the bony characters, but more like newer characters. Like for example, in the preview, you saw like Rick and Morty or Cuphead and Mugman. Like just those. I got to get used to it, like how the movements work and all that stuff. So hopefully that answers your question.
That's what I would ask. Your most difficult voice to perform, or character to portray.
I will say this. I would honestly have to say my most difficult thing was probably the Joker, because like, here's the thing. I was really trying to nail the Joker's laugh, I studied a lot of Mark Hamill's clips and all that. For whatever reason, I couldn't get his laugh down right. That is, until one day when I got a sore throat. And that actually helped it sound better. I know that's like the exact opposite of what a voice actor should do, but yeah, apparently me having a bit of a raspy throat, sore throat, kind of helped me nail down the Joker's laugh. I don't know why, but it's weird how it works like that. So I would say, like, in that sense, that was probably the hardest to nail down. Like, I could nail down the voice, just the laugh was difficult. So
it's not really so much that it's hard to do a character, but there are some days where my voice doesn't want to cooperate, right? So, like, is that kind of an answer?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, okay, because, like, sometimes when you try to deliver lines, and, like, if you don't do it right, it sounds weird, but, like, if you, you know, keep doing it, it obviously can sound better. So, like, that helps?
Yeah, yeah.
Okay, cool.
I remember you mentioned, like, you did the voice of Luna.
Not Luna, Princess Luna, but Luna Cat.
Yeah, Luna the Cat, that's what, I was wondering, prefer the new voice of Luna or the original English Angela Lansbury?
Okay, you know what's funny about that? I prefer the new dub, but she preferred the old dub.
I'm with you.
Of course, I'm assuming you also watched it when you were younger, right?
Yes.
So it's like imprinted into your brain.
Well, just for and giggles, my sister and I, we watched the original, like, American dub, the deep-dubbed Sailor Moon movies. We watched Promise of the Rose and Hearts of Ice. And I'm all like, God, I miss Luna's old English accent.
I miss a lot of the old voices, to be honest. Like all of them.
I know, and especially like when it came to like chewing Sailor Moon out and whatnot. It's like, Serena, get your act together! It just had more personality, and I was like,
yeah.
Really?
It's like
nasal. Well, it's like, I like that, you know, it's being like redubbed to match the exact Japanese script. I do love that. I kind of miss the old actors, and especially for its time, it's good, you know?
Yeah, we all got different opinions, but it's just there.
It's okay to be wrong.
I tell him that frequently about the Sailor Moon voices.
All right, Len, you'll be our last. Make it special.
Last special.
Yeah, that's the plan.
So, this one is for Logan, and I'm actually here to relay a message from a particular pony that he has used in one of his animations. So, when you said that I was supposed to have a cameo in your show, you didn't mention anything about having my mane cut off. Now, I know it's no Lyra and Bomb Bomb, but surely that is an act of crime against such a beautiful coat as myself. So, I would love for you to answer for what you did.
Side joke.
Right.
I, honestly, it was like, so basically, okay.
Is that for me, by the way?
So there's a scene in Sonic Meets My Little Pony where, like, there's one moment where, like, the Tails doll throws a sword off screen, and where it turns out the sword, like, hits Sephiroth Freeze's hair or mane, whatever, and it just gives, like, this shortcut. It gets rid of his man bun, basically.
It's a month to grow back.
So yeah, that's basically it. So all I gotta say with that is, I'm sorry. It's for the joke. I gotta make the people laugh.
It grows back.
Easy for you to say, you're a Draconicus.
I could make it disappear permanently.
I guess that's it for the panel, I believe. So, thank you guys for coming.